Hi. Recently, I started playing Rise of Civilizations, quite a new game released in July 2018 and just in September on the iOS platform. It's a massive multiplayer online strategy game. It's quite similar to games like Mobile Strike, King of Avalon, Guns of Glory, a bit of Clash of Clans in there as well. So if you're familiar to those titles, you will probably recognize a lot, but it also has some twists of its own in there. So I think it stands out a bit on itself as well. And I haven't played it for long, but it seems quite interesting. And in this guide, I will try to explain the basics of the game. So if you're new to this kind of game, what's kind of important to know that it can be quite addictive, and the idea is you start a game, but the game just keeps running, the timeline keeps running even when you're not online. So you build your own city, but the city can be attacked when you're not online. And that this kind of thing can mean that you are very eager to always keep checking in on the game. Just be warned about that. It's very nice, but it can also be very time consuming. Okay, let's jump in a bit. If when you start this game, the choice you have to make is which civilization you are going to play with. This can actually change later, but this is kind of a way, it stands out from a lot of similar games, so you can have your own, choose your own benefits, choose your own geography. You don't have to choose it because of the benefits. You can also just choose Korea because you're Korean. I'm not. I chose it because I like the research speed increase that I get. But you might choose something else for other benefits, and actually later you can change. I didn't realize I could change later. Otherwise, maybe early on it might even be better to choose something else. Maybe I will switch and switch to something else later. You never know. But it's quite interesting. So when you start a game after the civilization selection, you get into kind of a tutorial. And if you're a first-time player, it's definitely good to just slowly walk through that tutorial. Don't click everything away right away. Some the very basic concepts are explained, which will be useful to get to know the game. And in the remainder of this video, I try to explain a bit more about other features as well. One thing that I always find very important when playing this kind of game is to bind the account. So if you, that means if your tablet or phone that you're playing it on gets lost or broken, you won't miss out on your game, and you can also switch it from one device to another. When you're spending money on this kind of game, then definitely that's going to be important. But if you spend a lot of time, it can also be a real pity if you lose your game. So if you go to the profile by clicking at the button on the left top, there is this settings menu at the right, and from there you can click on the account, and here you can link your account, and on iOS that is to Facebook and Game Center, Android, maybe other things, maybe email, I don't know, but definitely you should link it to something there. That is always a good step to do first when you start playing the game, and so that you make sure you don't forget about it. What is also important is to find an alliance to join. I have already joined an alliance. Normally, of course, you should choose an alliance that is of your language. I'm actually not German, but I do understand it a bit, and this was an alliance that was open to join and seemed quite active. And I'm actually located in Europe, so it is good for me to play with people who play in the same time zone. Think a bit about which alliance you want to join. Maybe try out a few. It's quite important that you do find an active alliance, many members, and active members, so not members, not players that only check in once or twice in a week, but players that do put in several hours daily. That's very very nice that you can really grow your alliance together. It's also a bit good if you intend to play long. Also look a bit at the social side of the game. It is important that you are playing in your alliance with some people that you like in most cases. It can get a bit boring if you just play your game and don't interact. It's it's good. And as an alliance, you also want to do things together. So try to monitor, is the alliance active? You can, for example, do this by how many helps you get or how quickly you get those helps. I will get into those helps later, but you can also look at the alliance chat. Let's look at that. This is the kingdom chat. This is one thing I find a bit cumbersome. Maybe there's a better way, but I tend to always have to go back to the kingdom chat first. Oh, sorry, that was, this is my alliance chat. That was just one person that had a chat with an individual chat. Okay, let's get away from there. Look at that. An alliance is definitely very important. What I haven't done yet, actually, but what you should normally do is teleport to your alliance. Once you start a game, you should get, at least when you join an alliance, you should get two of these beginner's teleports. They are valid for 10 days, so I started playing a little bit more than 2 days ago. And that will really, that will allow you to move closer, or it allows you to move anywhere, but you should use it to move closer to your alliance area, your hive, as they like to call it, where the other members of the alliance are also located. This makes it easier to collaborate on things together, to defend together. So that's something you should definitely do. Another thing, when you looking at a few of the buildings in your city, so this is your city, what you see in front of you now, the most important building is probably the city hall. You need to upgrade that one before you can upgrade any other building, and it also unlocks certain features, so definitely good to put an effort on that one. I can start it. So normally it might show some, normally it shows some requirements of other buildings, but in this game, once the requirements are met, you don't see them anymore. But like in other similar games, it's also one requirement always to upgrade a wall. And for most levels, it's a requirement to upgrade one of the other buildings as well. So I will now... the beginner's teleports will also be gone after the upgrade. Maybe I'll wait a bit. Maybe I first do my beginner's teleport. So the beginner's teleport is gone after 10 days, but also after you reach the next level of your city hall, level 8. Another important building is your academy, where you can do research. So there are actually two categories, for economic and military technology. So here you can improve all kind of different aspects of your account. So for example, how fast you can gather resources, I will get more into that later, how fast you produce resources, how fast you upgrade buildings, how fast you do research, that can all improve here. And then another one is the military technology section, where you have all kind of military boost, like, let's start one, like the attack of cavalry units. You can also unlock new cavalry units, for that I probably... shows some requirements, so that I still have to do, like getting the academy to level 8 and stuff like that. So that's quite interesting. Okay, when you start, always click on the alliance help so that other people can help you. So you see, you get these messages like Hellboy has helped you, which will deduct some time from the remaining timer. So that's quite useful, especially early on when those timers are still quite small. This will really can help you start a new research or a new building upgrade within quite a short time. So that's quite nice, the academy, to improve your account. Definitely try to make sure to always have some research going. So you have four troop training. If early on you don't have the same amount of building as me, it's just because you need to upgrade your city hall to unlock them, so they will become available automatically. So there are four different troop training buildings: the barracks, the stable, the archery range, and the siege workshop. And here you can give order to train new troops. So the better tier troops you need to research first, but you have already one basic troop type that is available. And upgrading these buildings will increase the training queue, the amount of troops you can train at the same time. So that's quite useful as well. So definitely try to upgrade those buildings as well. And another interesting building is this Alliance Center. This Alliance Center influences how much helps you can receive. So that's also a good building to upgrade, especially early on. It also influences how much troops can reinforce you. That's also very important. But yeah, very early on, it can really help you if you get a few extra helps to grow a lot faster, to make your buildings faster. So pay some attention to that. In general, keep upgrading all buildings. But I tend to, early on at least, focus on upgrading my city hall and getting the requirements for that up. And it can be very useful. Initially, you can only, if you don't do anything, you can only build one, upgrade one building at a time. But actually, I should actually also start another building. So it's actually good to use a second building queue, which I have. And that allows you to do two buildings at the same time. Initially, you get some items for that, and later maybe you can consider buying this for some credits or getting it in other ways. I haven't looked into that yet, but it's quite useful to do two upgrades at the same time so that you can grow your account faster. Okay. One thing that I already mentioned is like this help, these Alliance Centers, so these helps. You can receive helps, and you should also give your Alliance members help by just, you can click on the button above it. If there is a button above the building active, then you can help all Alliance members. So that's quite important to help each other. So what is a way to see how well you're doing is your power. You see this power, the 13,000 next to the avatar at the left top. And if you click on the avatar and click on the more info, you actually see a breakdown of your power. So how is it built up? It's built out of your buildings, your technology. Yeah, technology is the research, the troops power, how many troops do you have? And of course, the higher tier troops also give more power, and your commander power. Power in itself doesn't mean much, but often alliances say, okay, you need to be 50,000 if you want to join my alliance, and later you need to be 100,000 power if you want to join my alliance. So it's quite good to keep that growing, and it's also kind of a status within the game. So it's good to keep working on the power, but it should be more a result of what you're doing than a goal in itself. So in this game, you have various commanders. And see that here I currently have three. So these ones, so this is a named commander, and the others are just have a certain skill, like Dragon Lancer or Markswoman. I assume the named commanders that you can get are all related to your to the civilization you chose somehow, but I'm not really sure about that yet. Anyway, for now, the commanders all seem a bit similar, but you can choose to upgrade them with a Tome of Knowledge items that you get in various ways. And you can also, I cannot do that now, but once you reach 10, then I could go to 2 stars, and later you can get to 3 stars, 4 stars. But you also need items for that you can get in various ways. And you can decide, do I want to focus on one commander or various commanders? I haven't done a thorough investigation in that, but it seems to make sense to me to pick out one of your better commanders. And in this case, this one seems a bit better than the others. And then focus on that one and getting that to a higher level and using that in most of your combats. So just as a beginner, just focus on getting up one commander. Well, I will probably later, when I've looked into this more, write a separate guide and make a separate video on how to deal with those various commanders. Can be quite complex. I think there are a total of 28 or something, so that's quite a lot. And besides this XP, you have a talent tree for each commander where you can, whenever you upgrade them, you get talent points. You can assign those, and those give extra boost. I've gone a bit for an economic route here. I hope ultimately Maybe it makes me better, but I don't know yet. I haven't looked too much at it yet. You can maybe I should have just gone for more of a military route. So don't look too much at what I've done. I haven't done too much thinking about it, but just assign your points to get extra benefits. And there are also some skills that you can upgrade. So there's a lot of things you can do. It is actually quite complex. That's why I definitely want to make a separate video and guide on this. It's just just pointing out what you can do. And the tavern building that you can build that allows you to do kind of some recruitment. Most of the time you only get some items, but those sculptures and tomes of knowledge are actually useful to upgrade your commanders. So it's useful as well. Sometimes you get another commander, so that's going to be useful as well. And you sometimes for keys, if you have keys, you can open them, but also there's a cooldown timer. You get some free chest openings. Of the silver one, I think, is for a day. On the golden chest, there's a timer, I think, of 3 days, so that you only get once every 3 days. But of course, the rewards are also better as well. So that's quite interesting. So one thing you can do on the map, that's quite interesting actually. So you have here your city view, but by actually you can just scroll to go to the white map. You can actually go on and make it zoom out further and further. So that's quite, find that quite interesting compared to other games. You really have to switch with one button between three different maps, but here they have a way to gradually do that. Maybe just a certain gimmick that I like now that doesn't really add much extra, but it gives a nice feel for it. So when using this magnifying glass at the left, you can search for different things. So in this case, I'm not interested in those camps. You can use that for gathering later. Maybe you can look at it as well, but I'm for example interested in to find some barbarians that I can attack. So you select the target, then you select the troop composition. Well, still I don't have that many troops, so I just use all my troops, and I choose this my normal commander to attack. So they're doing that. They're going to attack the barbarians and hopefully get me some rewards. I haven't figured out yet why at certain times it's daylight and then nightlight again. Now it switches to night. Don't understand really how this time is going. It's not in line with my own time, at least not always. those barbarians actually cost you some action points, and if you're actively playing, it's probably good to hit many barbarians to get rewards until your action points are depleted, and they will automatically slowly recharge after that. So looking at your alliance, one other thing is looking at the alliance technology. Here, what you have your own technology, but you also have alliance technology here. In here you can donate some resources, but it also works with a timer, so you can donate some resources. And then you can, here you see the timer below this button that it takes almost 28 minutes for my next donation to be allowed. But once, you can help this way to do some research together. So to improve your alliance that all members can benefit from. So that's quite nice. There were some gifts as well. Let's just claim them. Always nice gifts. Okay. Another thing. So what I wanted to show here is these are general quests in the top, which you can use as a guideline for what you want to do next, and it helps you develop your account. You don't need to pay attention to that, but it can be nice. Below this, that is, these are kind of recurring tasks, and you should really try to get these every day. I've not been playing much today, so I probably won't get them, but really nice to get them every day. For everything you do, you get some reward. It's nice, but you also get some points. So for this reward for training 200 infantry units, I get 5 points. For defeating one barbarian troop on a map, get 2 points and so on. If you score 100 points in total, you also get this chest, and with all the other one, you also get the other chest, which gives you 100 gemstones, a golden key, and an epic commander. So it's quite some nice stuff. Magic box, I don't really remember what's in there. But so, yeah, I really go for this. Actually, I have quite some, so I can claim those. Those are, a lot of them are quite simple tasks that you will do anyway, but focus a bit more so that you get everything. So maybe I still come quite far. You can claim those extra rewards, which is quite nice, and it really helps you to grow your account further. So if you're going to spend a significant amount of time, definitely worthwhile to do all of these. Probably make a separate guide and video on this as well to help you a bit with those daily objectives. They're quite important. So one of the daily objectives that I haven't done yet, which are quite time consuming, so that's why I haven't really spent time on that, is for example the gathering. So I'm now not going to use all my troops, so with a certain amount of troops I gather there for some cropland, and maybe gather here for some logging camp with another march and another commander. So this way, this is always good to do at the end when you are finished playing. You think you're going to log off, just send out your troops to do some gathering, and that way you have some more resources the next time, which you might need to do your building upgrades and so on. Okay, so this is basically the basic concepts of the game. There's much more. Talk for the rest. I suggest you talk to your alliance members in the alliance chat. That is always good. They can give you some further tips. You can help each other. You can work together to do certain things. So that's always good to communicate in the alliance chat. And help each other, ask your questions there, or of course you can also ask me by leaving a comment. I hope this video was useful to help you get started. As I said, I will probably make some more videos. If you have any questions, or if you want me to focus on a specific topic of this game to provide more information on, let me know. That's always welcome, and thanks for watching this video.